Hey guys, Cat Demon 43, and back with another episode of Life is Strange, episode 1. And first, let me apologize, because my intention was to do a recording of this on Sunday or Monday, but that did not happen. And that's because I ended up getting sidetracked with a couple of things. One of which was work. I was just feeling very tired from work. The other thing was that I had been working on a book called Louise, A Vampire Story. It's a novel I'm working on, and it takes place in late 19th century France. And it's a first-person story of a girl named Louise who is turned into a vampire by that of a family friend. Just had some difficulty writing a chapter. It was just, my head just felt like it was just stuffed with cotton, and I couldn't think. And not to mention, I couldn't bring myself to record an episode because I didn't feel, it's not because I didn't feel into it, it's just like everything, my emotions and stuff was like, no, you gotta finish this chapter before you do anything else. And that's kind of what my mindset always sort of goes to. So, and actually also, I got involved in going to an event too last week, which is really cool, and I'll explain a bit about it.
Fuck this shit!
Oh.
Ow!
Hey!
That hurt!
Damn. I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
This action will have consequences. It's his fault for throwing the ball. Okay. Photo.
That would be nice, if the water blossomed Victoria into a nicer person. Now that's what I call instant karma.
Max, that was awesome. Thank you.
No problem.
No problem. You have quick reflexes.
Years of mad dodging skills. Bullies never change.
That's why you're better off.
You're smart. We should hang out more. Now I have to finish this stupid book.
Whoa, what?
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hold on. I think what I'm gonna do is take a photo, make sure I have that photo, then intervene. Yeah.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone.
Yeah, but I mean, like, you need proof, and yeah, she's pissed at me.
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
Man, I should have stepped in between Kate and David. That asshole was so over the line.
Well, what the... what just happened? Okay. What just happened?
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
Yeah.
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
Eh.
Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business?
No. I like helping Kate. Me, squirrel. I'm assuming that's Warren, but he's gonna have to wait. I'm in a new area.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied. I better go there soon to see if Joyce is still there. And get a burger. Good thing I don't have a car. Yet. Who toilet papers a bike?
Someone who's got nothing better to do.
The whole town is turning into one giant missing persons poster. Damn, somebody is seriously devoted to putting up these posters. Now this really pisses me off. So entitled. Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard.
Yeah, that's kind of a dick move, you know? Audrey's a puppy dog.
That dog looks peaceful asleep, but if I get too close, Cujo.
I have no idea what Cujo is.
That layer of dust is begging for my finger. It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it. I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
Oh right, there's Juliet. Hold on. You wait there, buddy.
I wonder how long before Samuel has to repaint that.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to me?
Juliet still looks upset about Zack and Victoria. I don't blame her. Hi, yeah. Juliet. How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry, I'm still screwed up.
Sorry about Zachary. He's such an ass.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
Have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a joke. Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He usually does. Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Hold on, Warren. I want to look at your car.
Look at Warren and his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man. And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car?
Nothing wrong with buying a used car.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem.
The awkward hug. Aww.
Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Yeah.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Technically, I have one. Really?
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
You can draw?
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw.
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck. I'll let you know.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
I guess, yeah.
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone.
I love Akira.
Which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
Do you have Berserk?
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
If you have Berserk on there, I will be very happy.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Yeah, a lot of vampire stories these days mainly are kind of in the... Not all of them, but like a number of them are very much in the romance category. And I'm like, cool, my vampire book isn't that. Again, mentioning the book that I'm working on. So, because there's like no romance in it whatsoever. So, well, at least for the main character. I'm not exactly sure if anyone... Cause I get a lot of... I find I end up getting some flack because people are like, oh no, I had romance. And I'm like, no. That's not how I roll with my books. I write how I want. And if you do not like it, then you can move on. Anyway, not at all.
Not at all. Sensitive is good, unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
Oh,
the right girl will, too.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
Yeah. Yeah, well, Warren's a science guy, so you might be able to explain this. Maybe.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds.
Yay.
Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right?
Uh-oh.
You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now, answer me, bitch!
Piss off, asshole.
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
Good.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me. I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Ooh, yeah, police probably wouldn't do anything, and he looks not okay. His eyes look red, dude. There is something with him. I'm getting that. Like, he's being a real egotistical asshole. Yeah, buddy, take a step back.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh, man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Oh! What
hey,
the fuck?
Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the
stop
principal,
that.
Or that whore
Wait,
in
no.
the bathroom!
Scratched your face, asshole. Oh.
Max? Chloe?
Oh, that's
no
Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren.
Go! Go! I got this!
Warren. No! Warren!
Get in, Max!
I'm so sorry,
Get
Warren.
Your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody messes with me! Nobody!
Fuck you! Okay, wow. Nice bobblehead.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, yeah. And thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield.
She's shy and timid. What do you want?
Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing. It'd be a little hard to explain this to her.
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
Probably not. No, she seemed to really like Seattle.
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah, must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Probably only for Mark Jefferson, because she seems to have a thing for him.
Only for Mark Jefferson. He was a pretty famous photographer in the 90s.
I was born in the 90s.
I always loved his work.
Those that can't do, teach. I'm glad you found a good reason to come back.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Ouch. She could have also called. Yeah, why the hell didn't you call? Honestly. Oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah, this one.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Bullshit. You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
Yeah.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Oh, awkward. Nice tats, by the way.
Broken? Man, are you cereal?
Wow, I haven't heard that one in a while.
Yeah.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
That car was floating on air for a second. Nice house. Could use a paint job. Oh, it's half painted. Paint job could be finished.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Okay. Thought my computer froze. Oh, boobs. Nice.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-führer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Give me a sec.
Is this a desk or a storage space? I think this junk swallowed her disks. Too bad I can't stream any music from Chloe's laptop. But I love how funky and outdated it is. She...
Oh, shoot.
She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned. She even covered it in punk stickers because Chloe doesn't give a shit. There's the power strip. I'm not into them. Too pretentious. Hey, that TV used to be in the living room.
Everybody lies. No exceptions.
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
Estimate auto repair, Chloe Price, Arcadia Bay, or... Oh my god.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember. Man, I remember this furniture. We spent all day painting it blue. Chloe loved that blue. Old cardboard boxes.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Damn. Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared. Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair.
Chloe's dad built this dresser. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height. Hard to believe Chloe was my BFF just 5 years ago. Chloe's trash overfloweth. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
Not much, really.
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy-flippin' morons and watch them twitch into a DJ dance death rattle. Take a photo of that.
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless.
Okay, Chloe, a metal box under the bed equals secret.
There we go. That explains it.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
This one.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love.
It's the other 355.
Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Should they?
What about her parents?
Are worried?
Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Yeah.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. These books have not been touched since the last decade. I see why.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. Act, React, or Die, a 21st Century Survival Guide. Whoa, Apocalypse Self-Help. Dog tags, sweet. David Mattson.
Chloe's mom married the security guard.
Joyce always loved her mail order catalogs of useless crap. Aww. Joyce has a little shrine to William. Her new husband may not be such a douche.
Holidays with William and Chloe. Aww. While she was pregnant. Aww. Oh, that's so cute. I do not want that bird to die, so I'm leaving it open.
Oh my. Chloe made this for Joyce on Mother's Day years ago. I see why she would keep it. Joyce still works at the diner, and Chloe's new dad is a security guard. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. The prices are late on their bills.
David and Joyce Madsen. Oh, that's not good.
Joyce looks happy. Chloe's stepdad might not be a douchebag after all. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products. I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay.
Plexotine. I've heard of Fluxotine, I just can't remember what it's
for. I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
Aww.
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
Yeah, when you lose a family member, a lot of people don't seem to realize, but when you lose, like, a family member, it just becomes... It's a lot... It's different, and it's... Especially if you're really close to that family member. Much like Chloe, I actually lost my dad. And it was really hard. Like, just trying to cope. And always hearing people say, oh, you just have to get over it. You'll move on. And I'm like, it's not getting over it. It's dealing with it. And I mean, I lost my dad. Chloe lost her dad. There's really no way of getting over it. It's just dealing with it. And trying to live your life, even though a big part of your life, your dad or your mom or whichever family member you are really close to passed away, can be really, really hard. And I really wish some people would actually kind of wake up and realize that it is not easy. It's never easy.
I'd love to go to Paris, too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland.
Aww.
Joyce still works at Tuwell's Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon.
Cereal, meat, milk, peanut butter. Chocolate cake. Oil, bananas, toilet paper. Yeah, toilet paper is a must. You cannot live without toilet paper. At least I think you can't. What's this?
Yum, that looks tasty. I do miss Joyce's cooking.
I need to really get off my butt and try more with cooking. Or Evan was being stupid. That hasn't been cleaned in forever.
Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted.
Huh.
Damn, it's the couch. We used to pretend it was a pirate ship. Looks like a shipwreck now.
Is it comfy?
Come on, open it, chicken.
Hold on, and I'm not chicken.
Prove it. You drink first, Max.
No way. It was your idea, Chloe.
Whatever. Give me that bottle.
Well?
Tasty. Very tasty.
Here, I want a sip.
Sorry, this is not for kids.
Don't be greedy. Give me some. Oh shit, the carpet! There's wine all over. What do we do now?
My parents are coming. Cover it up.
That is a big-ass TV.
If I took this picture, the deer would be standing on your ass. Brr. I can feel autumn pushing out the summer. We made this grave for Chloe's kitty. Poor Bongo. He never saw that car coming.
That is why you always have an indoor cat. You never let your cat outside. Ever. Because it can get eaten, or hit by a car, or heck, someone decides to be a complete dick and steal your cat.
That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now.
There's a random shoe. Okay.
Oh, I loved this swing. William made it just for me and Chloe. What do you truly want to do when you grow up?
Max, I'm already grown up. What about you?
Travel. That would be awesome. Explore the world, go far from here.
Far from me? Thanks a lot, dude.
Dude, you would totally come with me. I need a bodyguard for our adventures.
I would be like Lara Croft, except real. That would be majorly cool.
Totally. We'd have cars and boats and planes all over for instant escape. And no adults could tell us what to do.
Count me in. What would you do while I was bodyguarding you?
Maybe take pictures of our adventures. I would love to be a photographer. As if I ever could be.
Aww.
What are you talking about? Max, you are a photographer. Your pictures could be in a museum. Someday they will. I believe in you.
Okay.
I should be able to find the tools I need here. Nothing. This is so lame.
You just started.
Poor little deer. It's not enough to kill you. They have to display your head. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years.
Nothing wrong with having food in case something happens.
I wonder what's in those files up there.
Let's be nosy. Oh, shit!
Butterfingers! Kate Marsh? Why the hell would he have pictures of her?
She knows.
Okay, this is getting totally weird.
Kate Marsh, she knows something? Blackwell Academy parking. More food stuff.
This must belong to Chloe's stepdad. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera.
In here?
Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
Hold on.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get?
I can see why, though. I mean, that's why I said no to signing that, That thing, I just...
Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me.
How many times are you gonna repeat that? I was in the military. Right, we found those dog tags earlier.
Hmm. One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat.
Let's turn that off. Okay, what are you?
Boom. Precision screwdrivers. Except... I can't reach them.
Oh.
That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach.
Okay, turning you off.
Yes! You have mad skills, Max. I've got the tools. I should go back upstairs before Chloe freaks.
Why would she freak? I have returned.
Found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera.
Thank you.
So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
Yeah.
I was there, hiding in the corner. Damn, you're a ninja.
Not really.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Nope.
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I hope so. I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Yeah, we did. I did.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Like who?
Like who?
Like anybody. Stop stalling, sister.
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday, but I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera.
Chloe, you're great.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Uh-oh.
Yo, turn it off. Turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. Oh, you shit. Need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now.
Coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing.
Oh, God.
Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait. Is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh, yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order.
Oh, dear.
Whose is it?
Oh, God. I don't know what I would do.
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home. Especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. What if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon.
You were hassling Kate.
You don't have anything smart to say now, do you?
Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe.
Yeah.
And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy.
Oh, no.
I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, oh my God. Put that thing down!
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max.
I wouldn't call
He's
it
no
that.
Match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Okay, I think...
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody. Even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Well, I think I'm gonna... call it here. Oh my god, so much happened. Okay. God. So, what happened? I feel like I should have stayed hidden. Honestly. I should have stayed hidden from David. I'm gonna have to just sit on it, I guess. Marijuana is way better for you than, like, cigarettes or any of that nature. Like, it can help with anxiety, stress, stuff like that. You know, I have friends who do smoke it. I don't. Mainly also because I know my lungs are complete shit, and I have asthma, so, yeah. That tends to put everything in my life in perspective. Just, I have asthma, so there's only certain things I can do. Oh, God. But I also just didn't really care for smoking or any of that nature. So, yeah. Sorry again, guys, that it took so long to get this next episode up. I hope to get it up pretty soon. And I will also leave a link in the description to where you can read the book that I mentioned. And if anyone is at all inclined to leave feedback or any of that nature, it would be really cool to hear what you guys think of it, because it's kind of the first time I've ever really done a first-person story, and feedback, I find, is always really key, but if you're not into that kind of thing, I'm not going to pressure anyone. It's just, I'd like to know what people's thoughts are on my books. I've always been like that, just wondering what people think on what I write. And what their opinions are and stuff like that. Anyway, I'm gonna go, and I hope to see you all in the next episode of Life is Strange, and I think that one is going to be the last episode of Life is Strange. For episode one, I mean. At least I think. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway. This is CatDemon43, and I'll see you guys all again later. Bye!